Well, good morning, everyone. Good morning, Palantir, distinguished guest. Once again, my name is Mike Shin, and I'm Stephen Ecker's co-pilot. We're absolutely honored to follow Dr. Karp. Pretty tough act to follow, but we'll do our best. We're here to share with you a special journey. It's a real cool story about an ontology and how this one DNA strand evolved into three generations of use cases that made a financial difference for TrinityRail Industries. TrinityRail, we've been trading on the New York Stock Exchange for the past 50 years. We design, develop, manufacture rail cars. We lease rail cars. We aftermarket, repair, maintenance, parts and components, lease rail cars. So we're in the train business. And I forgot the clicker. Bear with me. So with that, the setup is this. Over the past 2 years, we have doubled revenue from $1.5 billion to $3 billion last year. And during this period of rapid growth, we faced the most turbulent, most daunting, most challenging supply chain constraint our generation has ever seen. And with that, we faced a crisis. How do you deliver cars with all those supply constraints? At our lowest point, we hit 67% on-time delivery. So we were in the pressure cooker. It was my fault, our fault, we were the fall guy. We were in the hot seat. We overcame that, obviously, because we delivered on the revenue. The way you do that is when you're 70% on time, because we're a steel business, we buy steel, we convert steel, we ship steel in rail cars. Rather than ordering a ton of steel, maybe you should order 1.3 tons. Now, at the time, we faced a $2.5 billion backlog, so we had confidence that we'll need that steel, but not everything matches up. And what happens is we had inventory challenges, and our excess inventory swelled. We had a problem, a big problem. When you have a big issue, why not partner with the world's best problem solver? In came Palantir, and with Stephen and my team, we worked in collaboration, developed a steel substitution algorithm so that we can utilize that excess inventory and buy less. The beauty of that equation, when you're in a hyperinflationary time where steel pricing goes up 2 to 3x within months, what we're doing is we're utilizing that excess steel, that inventory on hand, at the lower price and avoid buying steel at the higher price. And that spread contributed Trinity delivering stellar operating margins in Q1, Q2, and it shows in our stock price. Right out of the gate, the team knocked it out of the park. But we're not done. We got plenty of problems ahead of us. Now we're on to Gen 2, and my partner Stephen Ecker will share with us how we collaboratively solved the design challenge.
Yeah, so recognizing the success of the supply chain steel project, we started to ramp up our internal development of Foundry. Now, rail cars have a surprising amount of customization, and we pride ourselves being a built-to-order business. But when you have all this customization, it presents complexity in our production processes. Now, this is a challenge because there's multiple teams involved and a lot of factors to consider, like regulatory, commercial, and material availability when you're constructing a bill of material. And this, over time, leads to data silos. Now, operations was pushing for transformation, and we recognized Foundry as that tool to help accelerate it. So we were able to expand that initial POC of the steel supply chain ontology into what we eventually came to realize was an AI-powered product lifecycle management application. Now, this application was custom-tailored for railcar manufacturing, helps us unify our materials. So I'm going to walk you through a little bit of the application and the evolution of the functionality. So we start with the customer inquiry from our CRM. And then we created a model that scores the customer requirements against prior BOMs to give us the best starting BOM as a template to work off of. Now that I've selected the most suitable starting point, I can make changes and traverse the BOM, navigating, updating, editing. Here, I removed a rod right out of the bill of materials. Seems simple. Next step, though, we leverage AIP to enhance our part substitution algorithm using Gen AI. This helps us identify other part substitutions that we may not have considered. From our historical BOMs here, we found a lock nut that's 20% cheaper. I initiate the substitution. I can then customize the inputs, and in this case, I'm choosing a machine learning model that helps predict the price for stale and outdated cost sets. I apply the substitution, ultimately editing the BOM, and this may seem trivial, but there's a lot of lock nuts on a rail car. And then we took it a little further where we could substitute full packages of materials. For instance, I select an air brake package made up of multiple pieces of componentry. Again, I used Gen AI identifying suitable replacements, and I found a package that's slightly less expensive. And as I make these substitutions, I get a running total of the changes and the dollar impact. And then I have a fully functioning workflow where I could push to SMEs like engineering for review and approval before I push it to production. Now, this might seem like a simple app, but when you open up the application workflow builder, it reveals the underlying complexity. The historical BOM is made up, comes from multiple sources, and has complex relationships. We took all this, all these systems, and unified into a single ontology. In the end, there was about 200 tables feeding a single BOM. Finally, we had to encode all the analytics and models to help drive decision-making for the end users. When building with Foundry and AIP, this is all in one place, helping us to iterate faster. It's our AI in the back end. So you see the AI working? It's fully integrated. Without this, we would generally require complex integrations and orchestrations with the operational application. With AIP, it comes out of the box. Another thing our developers really loved was how easy it is to navigate and edit the functionality of the application. You can quickly spin up objects, and they're easily defined. Essentially, you're navigating or traversing the ontology and enhancing and updating your application. And last, I go back to the underlying data lineage. For us, we use this a lot as that control tower, helping us spot issues in our transform pipelines, assess data quality and access. And as our BOM structure is complex, this was used a lot. So to reiterate, for us, this fully integrated system helps us enable to build better, faster. With Foundry and AIP, we can do everything without significant need for front-end development. And then the ontology that we establish works as a foundation for other applications in our steel supply chain or supply chain and manufacturing function. Now, for Trinity, this would have historically been a large project, big endeavor. We are able to do it with somewhat of a learning curve, 2.5 developers, about 9 months. With that, I'll hand it back over to Mike.
All right, thank you, Stephen.
I'll tell you where we take it from there.
So, where are we going, third generation of this one ontology, solved inventory, solved design, we need to solve supply chain. The problem we had was the suppliers were not confirming that they're going to ship on time. At the height of our supply chain woes, standing this team frantically running around, chasing down our suppliers, are you going to ship on time? Are you going to ship on time? We find out they ship too late. The buyers are not doing their job. Their job is to order the material at most optimal cost, get that inventory down, as opposed to spinning our wheels, chasing down suppliers. We got another problem. So in comes Palantir, working with our team, again with rapid execution, developed an ASN, advanced shipping notice, best that I've ever seen. I've been doing this gig for 30 years. And the speed of their execution is phenomenal. On the inventory side, 3 months to get to a functional workflow with $30 million impact in bottom line. With the ASN, how it works is Foundry will send an AIP agent, I call it a chat agent, via an email supplier will respond to that inquiry. Gen AI will filter, review the email, and then confirm it on track. If not, it will elevate it to management. And with that visibility and transparency, we get attention, and they give us what we need on time. Sometimes suppliers don't want to tell us they're going to be late because what Jack Nicholson said a long time ago, you can't handle the truth. Mm-hmm. Yes, we can. If you tell us, we can adjust our production and cope with it. But ASN was, again, another solution to the problem. And with that, I'd like to close on this note. Once again, thank you very much for your engagement. A year ago, I had this aha moment when I met with Erez and Lila, and I'm going, here's a company that's world's best at finding bad guys all over the world, in remote places we'd never heard of, dangerous places. Well, in our P&L, in our balance sheet, and in our operations, all of you business people, there's bad guys in there. Foundry, go help, seek, find the bad guy, and neutralize the bad guy. So this is just the beginning. I always say, from this one ontology, from the root to the fruit, we got a long ways to go. And I'm here not to tout ourselves, but to motivate everyone here in concert, let's embrace this technology, embrace this company, and give us a tremendous momentum where it becomes a ubiquitous, obvious solution. With that, more speed, with scale, more affordable. Thank you very much for your time. Look forward to socializing with you afterwards. Thank you.